the home to cover your house payment? Is there an opportunity, or is there enough equity in the home or appreciation in the home in the areas that we've bought it in so that you can work with a bank more readily to protect yourself during that downturned period of time?
And there are some programs out there for mortgages to help refinance and lower payments.
Isn't that called loan modification?
Well, that's one of them. There are some where you have to be 90 days past due, but there are other programs where you don't. Right. You know, that we can go in and you can be, you can have 105% loan to value. In other words, you don't have to have the loan to value that you used to have because you're upside down on your mortgage. And we've got programs for people that we can help them lower their payment even though they may not have any equity in it at all, because they're in a situation where their housing value has gone down.
Okay.
So that's just one of the things that we do to kind of evaluate what they need to do.
Is when you're seeing how much somebody qualifies for, sometimes what you can qualify for and what the actual percentage that you truly can afford is not always equal. Do you actually, what do you go by? Do you deal with that?
That is a great question. Somebody says, I need to find out what I qualify for. Well, my first question is, what do you feel comfortable paying? Even though I might could qualify for $20,000 or $30,000 more in a mortgage than they want to pay, I'm responsible, at least I feel like I am, to make sure that when they get in it, they're not over. It's not overkill. They're not having to struggle every month.
Right.
Yeah, and I think that's important too, because let's say we get a sheet that says we qualify for 130, just as an example. We put in that criteria, 130. But what if I find a house for 100? What if I find a house for 90? That's what you want to be looking for. What is the right house? We know what our ceiling is, and we know what the top of that is. But it's more important. What is the right place? Is it a good investment? Is it going to appreciate and build wealth, not just in combination with how you finance it, but as an asset?
Mm-hmm.
You don't want to be stuck 15 years from now that a house that you're going to have to pay for twice or that has not appreciated.
Right.
It's all, and these days, you just need to take your time, make the right decisions, and pray, pray, pray.
One of the things that we'll do when we're asking those questions is we'll come up with an amount based on what they say they're comfortable with, and then we'll tell them what they can qualify for.
Sure.
Because then they get to make that choice.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I found a house that this price range and this payment doesn't really give me what I want, but you know, let me think about this a minute. After my tax deduction, maybe if I can pay a little bit more and get this house of my dreams.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
You know, and still not be put in a position where they're going to be hurt down the road.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So now that we've talked a lot about buying a home, is there anything else that we need to know about buying a home before someone would go out and get started doing that?
I think really the one thing that we stress in that process is when you sign the contract and when you make the purchase, that's an important moment. When you get an agreed upon price, but there's still a lot of time left in the process. There are inspections that need to be done to protect you, to make sure that there aren't things. And we always recommend you do those with real professionals. I know people have friends that can do inspections and their dad may be handy, but when it gets down to buying a home, you want to work with a certified professional home inspector that can look at that house. Well, they know what they're doing.
Right.
There's never a 100% guarantee, but it certainly minimizes the risk for you structurally, from a termite standpoint, from an air conditioning standpoint, roof, the biggies, you know, so that you go into this process with a relative comfort. I mean, you can get home warranties and things on houses, even if they're older now, that cover you for that first year to make sure that there aren't traps involved.
Mm-hmm.
The point is, there are still a lot of steps moving forward, but using professionals, working with a professional realtor, working with a professional inspector, working with a professional mortgage company.
So I'm hearing you say buying a house is not a time to cut corners.
Yeah, truly.
Okay.
Truly, well put. And it needs to be done intentionally, with intention in every step of the way.
Yeah.
Okay. So how about a quick 1 or 2 minute word on selling a home? Anyone who's interested in selling a home, what kind of steps is it okay to do it by yourself? I mean, because sometimes those realtor fees can be expensive and people are like, well, I want to try and get more money in my pocket. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, you know, I get that question all the time. Mm-hmm. And really there's two steps. Number one, there are some laws that you have to follow if you're going to sell your home yourself. Okay. So if you do not follow those laws, you are liable.
Okay.
So right out of the gate, just sticking a sign in the yard, you're liable. Mm-hmm. There are disclosures and things that you have to make as a homeowner to anyone that looks at your house, and following those rules are very, very important. Sure, everybody loves to save money, but if you're not working with a professional and you're selling your home yourself, you could be selling your home for a lot less than what it's really worth.
Absolutely.
And, that would be a bummer.
Yeah. And putting yourself at risk. Mm-hmm. That first 45 days that a home is on the market is the most critical. And so if your home's been sitting out there for sale by owner and setting out there for sale by owner and the prices have come up and down, you could actually really be hurting your home instead of helping it.
I can tell you from my standpoint, from the mortgage standpoint, it is so critical to me that we work like a team.
Right. Mm-hmm.
It just helps the process all the way through.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Thank you guys so much for being here today. I really enjoyed learning
a pleasure.
And if you guys have any other questions or need to know more from these guys, I know that their info will be on the website. But thank you for tuning in today. And remember that you are not alone. See you next time.
Business people and community leaders, as long as one person in your community has not reached the full potential that they have, your community has not reached their full potential either. So I hope you'll consider investing into the life of a child or even an adult, mentoring them so that they can reach their dreams and contribute to the success of those around them. We'll all be better for it. Count on it.